Today I'm going to show you how I made this piggy bank for my daughter Katie. She absolutely loved it. It's definitely a great project to make. We do sell the plans for this on our website with all 26 letters, so definitely be sure to check that out. There's a link down in the description. Without further ado, let me show you how I made it. Sticking down some acrylic to the StepCraft M1000 CNC machine to start a new project to make a piggy bank for my daughter. We do have the plans available for this on our website, so definitely check those out there. It includes all the letters A to Z. It's definitely an awesome plan and an awesome project, so definitely check that out. I'm using the 45626-K 90 degree V-bit to carve my daughter's name into the acrylic. A lot of people don't think that you can V-carve acrylic, but I'm here to tell you that you definitely can. This bit did a great job going through here at over 60 inches per minute and doing a really great cut without melting the acrylic, which is really nice to see. You can see there are a little bit of fuzzies there on the protective paper for the acrylic, but that's just a cosmetic thing of the paper. It cut the acrylic beautifully and couldn't ask for it to do a whole lot better. If you love this type of content, be sure to subscribe to our channel and go ahead and hit that bell so that you'll be notified on all of the new videos when they're released. Also, don't forget to follow us on Instagram at Tools Today. So next we're going to go through and chamfer out where we are adding these screws later on. This will countersink the heads below the acrylic. Then we'll drop that off and pick up the 51411 1/8 inch diameter spiral O-flute bit. And this will go through and it will pocket out for the holes for where these screws are going to go through. After that's done, we'll go drop it off and pick up the 51404-K 1/4 inch spiral O-flute upcut bit to go through and cut the profile on the acrylic. We went through here at a 1/4 inch depth per pass, so cutting through the acrylic in a single pass, and this thing did an absolutely amazing job cutting through this acrylic. It went through without melting at all at over 100 inches per minute and did a great job with a beautiful finish on the edge. Couldn't ask for a whole lot better there, and you can see what that looks like right here. So anyways, that is done, so now we can turn our attention to the wood. I clamped in a block of solid oak here up against the StepCraft work holding wasteboard. We do sell the plans for that on our website as well. And then using the 46415-K 1/4 inch down cut bit, we're going to go through and cut the coin slot here. I applied Aura Mask to this project just so that you could get a visual on film of all the different cuts that we're making, so it makes it easier to tell what we're doing. So now we're going through here. We're going to cut the slot for where the acrylic will sit on this project. So we're going to go through and get all of that done. The down cut action of this bit leaves a beautifully clean top surface, which is exactly what we want to see throughout this project. So now we're going to go through and pocket out the insides of the letter. And this is really cool to see it acting kind of like a Pac-Man going through here, just munching off bits of wood at a time. It's definitely really, really cool to see. So we're going to go down a full inch on this piece here. So that way we have plenty of room for the coins. And you can see that bottom surface finish is spectacular. Definitely really nice to see that. And all of the big chips that we have from cutting that. So now we're going to go through and do the outside profile of this letter. We're going to go through in four passes to reach a full 1 inch depth of cut. And you can see again that down cut action of the bit forces those chips down, which leaves a really nice clean top surface. Using the 46233-K 1/16 inch down cut bit, we're going to cut in all of the screw locations for where that acrylic is going to mount that we drilled out in the acrylic earlier. It went through in three passes, drilling just as much as the bit can handle. And now that that is done, you can see the acrylic piece fit in there really nice. Definitely nice to see that. So this material is thicker than we're able to cut on the CNC with the bit that I was using. So we're moving over to the bandsaw to cut the remainder of the material here. I find it easier to do this than trying to flip it over on the CNC and get everything lined up. Moving over to the router table, I'll use the 47090 1/4 inch diameter flush trim bit to just take all of the rest of the material off and flush everything up nice and smooth. After that, I'll use the MR0110 mini roundover bit. This bit has a 3/16 inch diameter ball bearing. You can get it into all of the tight locations cut out by the bit. It also leaves a small 3/32 inch radius roundover, and it does a great job just kind of easing that edge over for a nice smooth finish. So now that that is done, I'll just extend those holes down using a drill bit that fits the size screws that I'm using, and then I'll just sand over the edges to make sure that nothing is sharp. So now that that is done, we can go ahead and sign the back just like I do on all projects that I make for Katie and add a little note for her. I finished this piece using some Minwax spray lacquer in satin, and it did a really nice job bringing out the color of the oak. Now that we're at the end of the project, we can take off the protective paper on the acrylic and get that fully installed on the piece. The sounds here of it popping in are so satisfying. And it's definitely really nice to have a nice tight fit there. So we'll get everything nicely screwed down, and this piece is coming to a close. We'll get everything wiped off, and we are now ready to go give it to Katie. This is definitely a project that I love how it turned out, and hopefully you guys enjoyed watching it, but I will let Katie do the sign-off here. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Have a great day, everybody. Hey, Katie. I got something for you. We got you a new piggy bank. So what do you think these are? Do you know what letters those are?
A. I. T. Y.
Yeah. What does that spell?
Katie.
Do you like it? Yeah? You want to put some coins in there? All right, let's do it. And I definitely think that your piggy bank needs a few more coins. What do you think? There you go. Let's put all those in there, too.
I love coins.
Do you? What do you do with coins?
Spend stuff with it.
What do you buy? What kind of things do you like to buy?
Toys.
Toys? Yeah, you do like toys.
Lots of toys.
You like how the coins move in there?
Thanks for watching. Have a good day. See ya.
Thank you guys so much for watching. If you love this type of content, be sure to subscribe right over here. And for more great videos, click right over here.